Hello out there. My name is Coda, and I'm a senior engineer for Dell EMC, supporting many of our enterprise platform systems. In this video, I'll be going over the steps to view and update firmware within the Lifecycle Controller, or LCC. As you can see, we've powered on this system, and it's entered the Lifecycle Controller. From the home screen, we have two different locations to choose from as far as managing firmware. From the center here, we have a green arrow pointing up, and we can click Get the Latest Firmware. And as you can see, we've got a couple of different options to choose from as far as repository locations. For the moment, I'm going to click back. And the second item I mentioned is firmware update over to the left. And we have three items to choose from here. The top one being launch firmware update. And that'll actually take us to the screen we saw just a moment ago. For the time being, I'm going to move down the list to launch firmware rollback, and we'll come back to launch firmware update. Okay, from here we see the integrated Dell Remote Access Controller, and it's currently running 4.40.0.0.0 with the previous version of 4.22.0.0.5.3. From this location, I can actually click Apply with that item selected, and it will roll back from the current version to the previous version. I don't need to do that now, so I'll go ahead and click back. From the bottom of the list, we can view current versions, which brings us to this table here that lists all of the component names, their respective version, and the time and date that that version was installed. And I will click back. And finally, we'll go back up to launch firmware update. And once again, we have four different options to choose from. We can choose to point the Lifecycle Controller to Dell website, to an FTP server, a local drive, or a network share. For this demonstration, I'll go ahead and select network share. Click next. And here we have four different options to choose from as far as network shares. We can use SIFS, NFS, HTTP, or HTTPS. I'm going to use SIFS as I have a server available where I've prepared a shared file, or shared folder that is hosting my offline repository that I built using Dell Repository Manager, or DRM. So the top item here, share name address, is going to require UNC path, which I've got entered already. It's --, my IP address, --share, which is the name of my shared folder. Then I'll want to enter my username and password, and that's going to be the account that I need to authenticate against that file server. And lastly, we have file path, or update package path. This is LCC update 1.00. catalog.xml, and that's just the XML file that was created when I exported the repository from DRM. I'm not going to be using a proxy, so I will leave that blank, and let's go ahead and click Test Network Connection. It looks like that was successful. Let's click OK. And click Next. Okay, it looks like we have successfully connected to our shared folder, and we've got several different options to choose from here. So we've got available and current. For the moment, I'm gonna unclick most of these and select one item and click apply. Okay, with this one item, this shouldn't take very long. But what you'd expect is after this screen, the server is going to reboot, and it will actually enter the Lifecycle Controller once more. And all you need to do if finished in the LCC is to exit gracefully from there, and your server will once again go through post and then boot and enter your operating system if installed. That's all we have for this video. I hope this was helpful, and thank you for watching.